air transport, it is a quickest means of transport, and also it is very helpful for in the various emergency situations, like in the situation of floods, and even during the times of earthquakes, and even in the emergency situations and during the war times. Here it is the very useful method of transport system during these situations. Okay, already you came to know that one. National and international are the two important types of air transport, and in our India these totally were earlier, this national is called as Indian Airlines and international airlines, but Air India, and those were combined. Now they are combinedly working as Air India. These are combined and called as Air India, and this Air India is flying with the Indian flag. Earlier this was a public sector, nowadays private also private air transport is also there, private air transport like Jet Airways. In our Karnataka earlier there was a Kingfisher Airlines, Jet Airways, it is also private sector, and even Sahara Airlines, and even public sector, that Air India is also carrying the flights from India to other parts of the world and within our country. Okay, in our India we are having major airports, major as well as minor airports also find in our country. There are 141 airports are there, 141 airports are there, and among them 28 are considered as international airports. 28 are international airports, and in that one some of the important airports we have to know about is and who is responsible for maintenance of this airports in our India, that is called as the Airport Authority of India. Airport Authority of India is responsible for maintenance of this air transport in India. It is 141 totally airports are there, 28 are considered as international, and among them here the person, the authority which is responsible for maintenance of this one is called as Airport Authority of India. After this we try to know about the major airports where those are located in our country. Okay, some of the ports I am going to mention here in the map itself. If you go to, sometime the question will be there, in order to locate, in order to find or mark the major airports of India. And here it is in Delhi. It is in Delhi. So that is called as Indira Gandhi International Airport. Then if we come to this Mumbai, here in Mumbai we are having Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport. Then if we go to Calcutta, in Calcutta we are having Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. It is also one of a international airport. If you come to Chennai, here this airport is called as the name of Anna International Airport. And if you come to our Bangalore, that will be called as Kempegowda Devanahalli International Airport. And there is a Rajiv Gandhi Airport in Hyderabad. And next is Sri Guru Ram Das Ji Amritsar. Guru Ram Das Airport. And then Guwahati Gopinath Airport. and even Biju Patnaik Bhubaneswar. Biju Patnaik, the former CM of the Orissa, Biju Patnaik, and then Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Ahmedabad. Sardar Patel Airport, Ahmedabad. Then Veer Savarkar, here Veer Savarkar, Port Blair, Andaman and Nicobar. Veer Savarkar Airport. Then Nagpur, Baba Saheb Ambedkar Airport. Then Shillong, here Zwaki in Shillong. Then Varanasi, Lal Bahadur Shastri. Okay, they are the important airports what we find in our India, and they are major ports like Delhi and even Amritsar, then Ahmedabad, then Mumbai, then that is Guwahati, and come to the Veer Savarkar, Port Blair, Chennai, Anna, Kempegowda, Bangalore, and Rajiv Gandhi, Hyderabad, and Biju Patnaik, Orissa, and Bhubaneswar. Like this, they are the important airports what we find in our India. I think you got, you have to go through the map also and locating and marking the important airports of India. Okay, after this, let us try to know the other important concept in this chapter, that is called as communication. That is called as a communication. What is this communication? What is the meaning of the communication? Convenience of messages from person to person or from place to place. Place to place is called as communication. Convenience or sending of messages from one person to another person or from one place to another place is called as a communication. Means it is sending the messages. Earlier also this system was there. In those days birds or animals were used in order to carry the messages. Birds and animals were used. It is not a new thing. Even it was existed in the early days. Birds and animals were used in order to carry the messages in the form of letters from one place to another place. That is called as a communication. Okay, and it is very useful for communication is very useful. The uses of communication: transmitting ideas, transmission of ideas from one person to another person or from one place to another place. Communication is very helpful, and it is very useful for creating awareness among the people, about the government policies or about various things. This communication is very helpful. Nowadays it is also useful for creating awareness among the people regarding the pandemic and COVID-19 and taking care of themselves in the houses and how to avoid this kind of pandemic. That is creating awareness among the people about various government policies and development activities. And it also that is enabled to that is know about weather conditions or weather forecasting, when the rainfall is going to occur, or even it is providing messages to the people who are in the fishing grounds in the ocean or seas, and taking care of themselves and take precautions. You know about weather forecasting and even other various kind of natural calamities. It also helpful. The communication is helpful for those people, and it also helps for the maintenance of integrity of country. In order to feel Indians as a one and India as our nation. For that purpose also this is very useful one. And among this communication system that is classified into two. One is personal and mass communication. personal and mass communication. Communication is classified into personal communication. What is personal communication? From one person to another person, that is in the form of letters, and that may be in the form of telephone, and that may be in the form of mobile services. It is also the fax, then email. They are the internet services, internet seminars, then conferences. They are called as the personal communication. And if it is considered as public communication, mass communication. Second type is a mass communication. In the mass communication, we come across the concepts like newspapers, that is provided for the mass, for many people, and radio, then the television, and even magazines, books. They are considered as a mass communication. Okay, communication is divided into two. One is personal communication and mass communication. In the personal communication, we come across telephone services, letters, mobile services, fax, email, internet services, seminars, conference. In the mass communication, we come across newspapers, radio, television, and magazines and books. They are considered as a mass communication. We can communicate in a quantity, and in this one we can communicate in a personal manner. That is the two important types. Okay, in this communication system, we try to know about the first is postal services. Postal services, postal system of India. It is a very old system of India, and still it is existing, and it was started during the British time. And the post offices are providing various type of services. The various type of services they are providing, and that is providing sending the letter from one place to another, then the packing materials from one place to another place, and even the parcels, and providing the facility of deposits, providing pension to the old age people. And nowadays they are also providing other various type of facilities like insurance facilities and banking facilities also they are providing. Banking facilities, depositing of money, also providing by the postal bank, that is posts, and they are the one of the important method of communication system. Okay, after post, let us try to know about the another thing is radio and televisions. Radio and television, it is also very important method of communication system. Radio and television, they were earlier radio had very much importance, because that is the messages or information can be sent to the remote regions and very far away places, and even the villages. Here radios were played very important role. Nowadays in place of radio, television is playing very important role in order to discuss various matters, in order to communicate the information to the people in the various places. This television is playing very important role, and they are giving information. They are giving information about the agriculture to the farmers. Various programs will be there for the farmers about the crops, about the market, about the prices, and about the fluctuation in the market. All these information and methods of agriculture, these information also they are getting with the help of television. And along with that, they also get information for the education also. Nowadays, because of pandemic, the televisions are providing educational programs to the students. And along with that, it also very helpful for the other fields like weather forecast. Weather forecast. The information will be given in the television regarding the weather forecasting and how to take the precautions. Now, this is about radio and television, which is playing an important role. And when it was started? It was started in the 1913 in our India with the name of All India Radio. All India Radio. And the television services were started in India during 1959 in the name of DD, Doordarshan. And nowadays, these Air India and Doordarshan is merged. And they are playing very important role in the communication system of our country. Okay. Next is another important communication mode or method is newspapers. Newspapers. They are the printed mean of communication. Printed mean of communication, and they are also playing very important role in the communication. Okay. Newspapers. In our India, there are more than 1 lakh newspapers. 1 lakh newspapers are printed in our India, and 1 lakh type of, not number, that is quantity. It is they have different names. 1 lakh papers are there, and they are in the various languages of our India, and in every language, different papers are there, and here we are. 41 papers, 41 newspapers are having a history of 100 years. 100 years history, 41. And the oldest paper of our India, which is still in printing and it's still in circulation, that is called as Bombay Samachar. Nowadays it is called as Mumbai Samachar. And it is in Gujarati language. It was in Gujarati, it is in Gujarati language. And it was started in the year 1822. In 1822, this newspaper was started, and it is about the communication system and particularly about the newspaper, how they are playing very important role, and the oldest paper of India, and how many old papers are in circulation, in which year the Bombay Samachar was printed or started or published. Okay. After this, another method of communication is satellite and computer networking. Modern methods, satellite and computer networking. Nowadays, these satellites are very important one in order to carry the messages from one place to another place with the help of artificial satellite system. This is working, and they are playing very important role in providing the information from one place to another place. It is and in this one, three important things we are going to know about. Three important things we are going to know about. One is called as GIS system. And what is GIS? It is Geographical Information System. Geographical Information System. It is collecting the information of a particular area, and data will be collected here, and that will be based on accumulation of internet data, accumulation of data, and providing that data to various places. That is called as Geographical Information System. Geographical Information System. And that is the one. Next is about the GPS system. GPS system. Global positioning system. Global positioning system. It is very useful, and it is in order to position a particular object, in order to position or find or locate a particular object, and that is called as a GPS system. Here, finding a particular latitude, then longitude and altitude of a particular object. One object, where that object is, in which latitude it is, in which longitude it is, and in what altitude, above sea level, where that object is there. And that may be a moving object or a stationary object. That may be a moving vehicle or a moving person or a moving object, or that may be a stationary object. In order to find out that one, this GPS system, global positioning system, is very important one. And last one is that is a remote sensing. Remote sensing means here to find out the distance between one object and another object. Distance between one object and another. That is the intention of this remote sensing method. Okay. This is the various information what I have given about the transport and communication system in India. Much information you have got. And this is a very lengthy chapter also, and very useful and very easy to understand, because many things what you come across and what you are seeing in your surroundings, in your environment, those things are covered here. And you go through this whole video. While watching the video, whatever points I have mentioned on the board, if you find those one, if you also can get the screen shot of that important points also. And even while listening the video or seeing the video, you have to point out the important points what I am going to mention here. It is very important one for you, and I think to much extent I have able to reach you in order to communicate the chapter transport and communication. Okay, thank you. You have to share this video as well as subscribe this channel, because it will be helpful for others also, because of this pandemic conditions. So they will it is very helpful for revising the syllabus also.